In this problem, we have a piston and cylinder system again, two components. It's in the vapor phase at 1 bar. In the liquid phase, these components are not miscible. And it asks us to plot the partial pressure of just one component as a function of total pressure as the total pressure increases to 12 bar. So initially, we're starting out with just a vapor phase, and it says the vapor mole fraction of component A is 0.4. So we're starting out the mole fraction of 0.4. That's at the start. Of course, that's going to be the overall mole fraction. It also gives us saturation pressures. It's 2 bar for component 1, and it's 4 bar for component 2. And it asks in this plot to indicate what the scales are on the axis and the reason for the shape. So the question is, we want to plot the pressure of A versus the total pressure in the system, and we want to go up to total pressure of 12 bar. So in this problem, we start out at a total pressure of 1 bar, so that means the pressure of A, since it's only vapor, mole fraction of A times the total pressure, mole fraction is 0.4, so we're at 0.4 bar initially. So total pressure 1 bar, we start here. As we increase the total pressure, we increase the partial pressure of A, just ideal gas behavior. The partial pressure of A is going to be the mole fraction of A, which stays at 0.4 as long as we just have vapor phase, times the total pressure. And so the first point where we're going to see a change is when one of these components gets the saturation pressure. Since the saturation pressure of A is much lower, we expect A is going to condense first. So when saturation pressure of A is 2 bar, so when the pressure of A, which is the mole fraction of A times the total pressure, is 2 bar, we expect to get constant condensation. That means we expect that when the pressure is 5 bar, A starts condensing. And the important thing to keep in mind in this problem is that components A and B are immiscible, which means that A and B in the liquid phase exert their saturation pressure independent of the presence of the other component in the liquid phase, because they're in completely separate phases. We have pure A in the liquid phase and pure B in the liquid phase. And so we're going to get condensation. The total pressure is 5 bar, and that's the point where the partial pressure, so 5 bar, so the pressure is going to increase. This is all vapor, and at this point, A starts condensing. And now as we continue to increase the pressure, pressure of A is going to stay at 2 bar because we have liquid present, and so we're at saturation conditions. So as we condense out A, then the partial pressure of B increases. So the mole fraction of A is decreasing, the mole fraction of B is increasing. And at some point, since the saturation pressure of B is 4 bar, at some point we're going to get condensation. So we're going to get a point where pressure of A, so total pressure is the pressure of A plus the pressure of B. Well, once we have liquid present, A is going to be at saturation pressure. And the question is, when does B get to saturation pressure, which is 4 bar? Well, that's obviously the total pressure of 6 bar. So we get to pressure 6 bar, right? The pressure of A doesn't change. But now at this point, we have liquid A, and we have liquid B, and we have vapor. And now we try and increase the pressure more by pushing down on the piston. The pressure of A can't be higher than 2 bar at equilibrium. The pressure B can't be higher than 4 bar. So if we try and increase the pressure anymore, it means that we will no longer have liquid phase present, vapor phase present. And so we would see all the partial pressure of A in the vapor phase drop to zero. And so as we increase the pressure now, we only have a liquid phase, right? So this is all liquid at this point, and no partial pressure of A in the gas phase.